Hey guys, Corey here. Back from my little 3 or 4 day vacation that I had fishing. So, back on the scene of a carpet stretch here in Austin. It's gonna be a two roomer. May include a haul. I don't know exactly how everybody, you know, does their stretching. Some people do it by square foot. I do it by kind of by the seat of my pants, basically how difficult it looks. And the way this would work is it would be a whole lot cheaper if the hallway would stretch with it. So let me show you. I got the exact same situation in two rooms, so hang on. This room here needs to be stretched. I'm gonna take it that way, and it would be just great if this hall would stretch enough with it to hide the wrinkles, but it just probably won't. So I'll probably have to cut it here and pull it together. Now, got another one of these just like this. Right here. So this room needs to be stretched. Those cutouts don't make your job any easier. Neither does the closet. So it needs to go this way. And then, this guy. So there's just no way this guy's gonna make it, so. But I like to see, you know, what I could make happen. Just even though it's beyond reason to think that would stretch, still fun to see what you can make happen. So we're starting in the other room. So I will probably won't be doing any or much, what do you call it? Basically setting up the camera and showing me actually the work. I'm probably gonna vlog it in sections today. So anyway, I gotta make sure to not open that window because it'll blind you. All right, I'm pretty tired and I'm about to get started. All right, I made it work without cutting into the hull. So you can defy reason. There's no reason to believe that this carpet could be stretched right there without opening the hull up, because there was two walls indicating it probably wouldn't work, but it did anyway. And I did it with this guy with no poles. So here we go again with the crowd that thinks they don't stretch beyond the back feet. So if the back feet are here and I stretch it all the way to the door, you can clearly tell that it does stretch beyond the back feet. Moving along. I'm gonna pick up everything and put it over here. This one is no real picnic. I'm not, probably a little less happy to see this one than I was the other one. So now the odds of getting that one to go is just not gonna happen. I don't see this happening, but you know, we can give it a real good try here to see if I can stretch that out without having to cut this open, because I don't wanna cut it open. I don't feel like it. I don't wanna cut that open. So give it a shot. Oh, and it was, or is rather, another Home Depot install. When I pulled up the carpet, it had that Home Depot pad underneath it with their little logo on it that says, "I wasn't stretched during installation." That's what they need to start putting on that pad. I was not stretched during installation. All right, I will turn the light on. I'll be back. All right, I've had phone call after text after phone call and all this other business, so I've got this. Won't take that much out over there. We'll take a look at that in a minute. So I've got everything stretched out here. Turned out fine. This guy here, it still needs my attention, but I'm still being a little stubborn about I don't really want to cut into that. So I'm going to try to stretch right here, and then maybe taper it off that direction a little bit. See if maybe, just maybe, pull it out that way. It's a short enough pull and direct enough without really anything in the way that I believe that I can trick it into stretching. Here, there's a lot of limiting factors, and it's still stretched a little bit, so let's see what I can do. See if I can save myself you know, 20-30 minutes. All right, guys, we are done now, and I'll tell you how I got this stretched here. All right, this done, got this done here. This one took off over there. So basically, to stretch this, I just didn't want to cut. I didn't want to cut this. So for what it was going to cost to cut this open and seam it, I stretched this room for the same price, which we weren't going to stretch. And this room got a stretch and fixed that problem too. So we kind of killed two birds with one stone. Saved myself probably as much time. A little bit of time I probably saved rather than having to. I just didn't want to cut into it and seam it together. So I probably saved a little bit of time by stretching it that way. So got that issue solved there. We're all good there. I'm gonna turn this fan off. All right. In the other room, we've already seen, and it got stretched. The hallway got stretched in unison with the room, which I was really pleased with. The other one, I didn't think it was gonna work, so I snuck it from the other side and stretched it the other way and made it work and turned out better for everybody. That's what came off this room. This one was really, really Home Depot loose. Really Home Depot loose. So I'm getting ready to pack up all my toys here and drive a few minutes across town and go stretch and clean another room. And then beyond that, I've got two closets to install, I believe. All right, guys, that concludes this carpet stretch. So I appreciate you watching, and as always, if you have questions, you're always welcome to text. I noticed that I missed a few texts on a few messages on Facebook Messenger from a couple of guys that had questions, and they come through like a month or so ago. So if we're not actually friends on Facebook, it goes into like a junk folder and I'll miss them. So you're always better off texting me. Your text is better than email. If you text me and you don't hear back within 10 or 15 minutes, that means I didn't get it, because I return all text. I'm always happy to help anybody that needs me. So the number is 512-350-1129. So shoot me a text if you have questions, and I will see you on the next job. God bless.